Yep, we have all been there. Flying a helicopter in a rising storm through Vietnam ain't as easy as it seems. I'm Hicks Decade, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to fly the transport helicopter, the Cobra, the gunner seat for the Cobra, the Loach, the Bush Ranger, and even the gunner seat for the Bush Ranger. Basically, everything you need to know when you're choosing the pilot. If you're not already an experienced pilot, you might not gain much from this video, but please, feel free to stick around. Now before jumping in the game and play, we want to set up the settings, so choose settings. Once here, we scroll a little bit down till we get to aircraft and vehicle. Now there's also something called advanced fly model. The box is not checked by default, so make sure this is checked. If it's not checked, the game will try helping you fly the helicopter by guessing what you want to do or remove some of the controls. So make sure it's checked. Now you have total control of the helicopter. Then we move to player view and hook. And up here we have field of view. Now crank this up to the top. It makes sure that trees doesn't pop in as you fly. It simply just looks better if your computer can handle it. Then we go down to key bindings. And then we scroll down, down, down until we get to the helicopter. Now there, we can put up the keys as we want them. If you're thinking, hey, what if I want to fly with joystick or joypad, can I do that? Well, as I'm making this video, you can't, but the developers have said that this is something they want to include in the future. So I'm gonna be flying with keyboard and mouse. Now make sure to push apply so you save your change. And then we go back. And no, we're not going out on the service yet. First we're going in tutorials. Then we're gonna push free play. And here you can see we have a helicopter range. Now this is the Enlau Valley map. It's a good place to train for beginners because there is nobody there, so you won't get killed. By others, anyway. Once in, we can choose between combat pilot and transportation pilot. We're gonna pick the transportation pilot. This means we can only fly the Bell UH-1, also known as the Huey helicopter, my favorite helicopter of all time, by the way. And when we get inside, you can see that the main rotor immediately starts to pick up speed. Now take a look at the gauge down at the left corner. You can see it start building up revolution per minute, in short, RPM. Once it reaches the middle of the green, we have enough RPM for liftoff. We are now ready for liftoff. Push the collective pitch button to go up and turn it down to go down. You can see the white stripe in the middle gauge where your collective is. Now let's get back up there. Once hovering, we can use our tail rotor to turn the helicopter around itself. Now this is very useful when coming in for a landing and there might not be enough room. Just know that you can't really use the tail rotor in high speed. When we're sitting in the helicopter, we can push our free look button to look around. Again, very useful for landings, or we just want to know what's going on without turning the whole helicopter. A common mistake many new pilots do is they try to fly the helicopter as you will drive a car in a video game. But here, you have to imagine that you are hanging underneath the main rotor and you have to lean in the direction you want to go. I'm leaning forward, thereby going forward. Now let's talk about your first landing. What I want you to do is aim for the rice field, push the other hover button. As you can see, it turned yellow, it built up, and it's centering the white dot. It did this all by itself, I just pushed the other hover button. Now once hanging here, we can turn down the collective once again. You can see we start losing altitude, coming down for an easy, safe landing. Now I wouldn't advise you to do this out on the servers, because you will get shut down, but in the beginning, this is quite a helpful tool. Now the second landing I'm going to show you, we are not gonna be using the other hover button. In fact, as you get better, you will be using this less and less, until at last, you won't be using it at all. So first, figure out where you want to land. And personally, I always like to come in low when I'm flying the Huey. Once we are getting closer to where you want to put down the helicopter, turn the collective down to the bottom, lift your nose up, and then slowly lever the helicopter out. There you go, nice and easy, but more importantly, faster. If you ask me, how long you should be flying around on this practice map before going out on the servers, well, I would say, if you can take a helicopter, land all four places where there is yellow smoke, return to base without crashing once with all the helicopters, well, then I would say you're ready to go out on the servers. It is easier flying around here though, because nobody's shooting at you, nobody's yelling at you. It is time well spent. But speaking about servers, how about we take this tutorial and get out there in public, because let's face it, it's more fun with people. We are now out on the public servers, and we're gonna be sticking with the Huey pilot as I show you two more landings you need to learn. On the third landing, we do as we did in the previous landing, only this time we make a sharp turn. Doing this, we will drop faster in altitude and get down on the ground. Up with the nose once again and leveling the helicopter out.
Thank you, Hex. Thank you, Hex.
Charlie. My pleasure. Good luck out there. The last landing, you could almost say that it isn't a landing at all, because you never touch the ground, but instead you're just hovering over it. This can be quite useful if you're not sure if you can actually land there without losing the main rotor. If you're coming in for a landing with too much speed, quickly put up your nose and turn up the collective. It sort of works as a brake, and you can end up having a safe landing after all. And speaking about landing, try to land on a flat surface. Sometimes even the smallest hump can kill you for some reason. Being a transport pilot means you have to fly soldiers into the battlefield, and having a helicopter you can fly them in behind enemy lines, giving your team a little advantage. If you look down at the left corner, you can see an outline of your helicopter, and all the green dots are symbolizing how many you have on board. And when you see the thumbs up symbol, means that you are close enough to the ground for your passengers to jump off. When they do so, you get 5 points for each of them, but if you notice some of them is not getting out, you can push your get out button to remind them that they have a job to do. But every once in a while, you'll get a guy who simply just won't get off the helicopter. That's probably because he's going for the achievement, Get Some, where you have to kill 25 enemies as a helicopter door gunner. Most pilots get pretty annoyed by this, but personally, I don't mind. It's nice having some company, and you can actually have some pretty fun gameplay. Take these clips here for example, with a random guy I met once.
Dude, don't land. Keep going. All gun. Keep going. Got that tunnel. Here's up. Oh, bro.
My rotor is shot to shit. I have to fly back and get it fixed.
Got one!
Well, that was not one of my better landings.
Good run.
Now, as you can see, having a door gunner is not a bad thing. When you do fly the Huey helicopter, squad leaders on the ground can choose you as their main pilot. That means that their squad members will spawn on your helicopter. Plus, You get points every time some of these squad members capture objectives on the ground. Another way squad leaders can help you out is by marking an LC, short for landing zone, with yellow smoke. If you see that from the sky, you can come down for a safe landing. However, if the smoke is red, means that it's a hot LC and there are enemies nearby. And you should find out with yourself if you want to go in for landing or not. The squad leader is not choosing if they want to use yellow or red smoke. This happens automatically. Now to something important. When you start flying the transport helicopter, getting soldiers from A to B, 90% of the time they will hold you responsible if you do not manage so. So you can end up meeting some really angry people. This next clip here will give you a little taste of some of these people you can end up meeting.
Hey, are you gonna land this fucking thing, or are we gonna do a world tour around this fucking map? Oh yeah, here's a great idea. Let's land it in an enemy encampment, right on top of it.
Hey, dude, here's an idea. Quit being an annoying prick. No one likes you.
Recon is in the air.
Taking fire. Anyone hurt? What was that?
Yeah, instead of landing in an open field where there's absolutely no enemies around and we can easily walk in, I'm gonna land right where there's like a huge group of enemies and get everyone killed.
At this point, he's just warming up. He then continued telling me how much I suck and tried to vote kick me. But when this doesn't work, he changed his role into a load pilot, starting killing me on the airfield and destroying my helicopters on the ground. My point for telling you this is you're going to meet people like this, and they're gonna tell you, don't take the Huey pilot if you can't fly the helicopter. Well, I disagree. You wanna get good at being a helicopter pilot? You just keep on flying. Just keep on flying. But once you do get good, and you can start pulling off more difficult landings, and people start spawning on you all the time, well, that is where it begins to get really fun. Alright, so we're not quite done with the Huey, but I think it's time to move on to the next helicopter. Bell AH-1 Cobra, armed with rockets, miniguns, and grenade launcher. This helicopter will make the enemy shit their pants when they hear you coming. But if you can't fly the damn thing, the only one who's gonna be shitting his pants is your gunner. So let's take it from the top. First, pick combat pilot. Then, when you get up to the Cobra, make sure to take the back seat to fly the damn thing. Now, just as before, the RPM will build up by itself. And since we already covered all the landings, let's talk about flying it. Oh yeah, and before you lift off, make sure to get the gunner on board. The first thing you will notice when you start flying the Cobra is that she is a heavy girl. So all the things you can get away with in a transport helicopter, you can't in this one. She needs more time before she starts climbing after a sharp turn. Remember I said earlier that I always like to come in low? Well, not this one. The Cobra is the exact opposite. You wanna be gaining altitude. There's no reason for you to be flying around in the trees, but the chances are you're gonna be hitting them sooner or later. So I might as well tell you, as long as the trees are made in 2D, you're not in danger of crashing. But before you decide to go deer hunting in the forest of 2D, just keep in mind that you can't stay here forever. Your propeller will take damage sooner or later, but we'll get back to that one. The second thing you will notice when you fly the Cobra is that it's quite good at levering itself out, which means that it's easier to hit the targets. And speaking of targets, let's talk about the weapons. When you fly the Cobra, you can use your minigun and the rockets. To use the minigun, you need to push the same button as your melee attack. And if we zoom in, you can see that we are not hitting the center, but a little to the left. Luckily, the minigun is so powerful that we don't actually have to hit the enemy, but just close enough. That is enough. To use the rockets, press the left mouse button and the right one to zoom in for a better view. The rockets you are firing fly pretty straight and deal a whole lot of damage. Unfortunately, you don't carry that many compared to the minigun ammo, so you might want to consider not using it all at once and put a little more fate into the minigun. So what is your job as a Cobra pilot, apart from killing the enemy of course? This is your job, destroying spawn tunnels. Soldiers on the ground can do this as well, but you have a great advantage from the sky, and you can use all your weapons in your disposal. When you destroy a spawn tunnel, the enemy has to start from the original spawn, run back out there to put up a new tunnel. The time they use to do so is helping your team. Every time you take out a tunnel, you get 10 points, and 5 points for every kill. If you run out of ammo or your helicopter is damaged, you can fly back from where you came. Once you land, you will get rearmed, your helicopter will get fixed up, and you can even pick up your gunner in the case you have lost him. And a quick side note, try to stick to your own helipad. To make sure you're not flying blind and hitting friendlies on the ground, push your tactical view button. Now you can see who controls what and even enemy movement, which makes our job a lot easier. So let's switch seat here for a minute and talk about the Cobra Gunner. You still have to be combat pilot, but instead of getting in the back, you get in the front. As Gunner, you don't have to worry about flying the Cobra, which means that you can put more energy into fighting. So the first thing you need to do is scroll forward with your mouse wheel to access your weapons, and zoom in if you want. The turret you control is armed with a minigun and grenade launcher. Although not as powerful as the Cobra pilot's rockets and minigun, you do have a small advantage that you can turn your turret and pick up targets that the pilot might have missed. And depending on the player flying the Cobra, the chances of him running out of ammo before you do is quite big, so there's no reason to be holding back. When using the minigun, we have to get a direct hit to kill the enemy, but even though we might miss, we mustn't forget the value of suppressing fire. The grenade launcher has a little more kick to it, but it doesn't shoot straight like a rocket. It always feels like it's falling a little short of where you're aiming. But this depends on the speed and angle of the Cobra, so it takes a little practice to master. Since you don't have to concentrate about flying, you can help out your pilot by keeping an eye on the map and tell him what you see by using the vehicle voice chat. Don't attack Charlie, we have friendlies moving in. As you can see, you and the pilot are two working parts of the same machine. Remove one of them and the Cobra will not be as effective. So what happens if you are a gunner and the pilot gets killed? Are you then doomed to go down with the helicopter? Well, not necessarily. In this next clip, I will show you what to do. In a few seconds, the pilot will get killed, and it's up to us to save the helicopter and ourselves. Shit! I got this! Yes, nice save! Good work, Betty! Good work! Wait? No? No, no, don't go down, Bertie. Go up, climb up. No, I've lost many helicopters, but I won't lose you. Come on, Bertie, you can do this. I believe in you. I know you can. Come on. Come on. Up, up. Yes, yes, yes. Atta girl. Atta girl. Come on. Let's go home. Alright, so all this went by a little fast, so let's go back, rewatch it, as I walk you through it. First, we need to realize that the pilot has died, so we must always keep an eye on the little helicopter down at the left corner. Once the pilot is dead, we can take control of the helicopter. So first, scroll back with the mouse wheel to let go of the turret, and then scroll even further back to take control of the steering. Immediately, we want to turn the collective all the way up, in the case that the pilot has turned it down. From here on, you can fly the Cobra as if you were the pilot, although you can't use the weapons, and it feels a little bit strange sitting out in the nose, it's more or less the same. But since you can't use the weapons, all that's really left to do is fly back to base and pick up the pilot. And once you land, you will automatically let go of the steering. So what happens if one or more combat pilots can't agree on who to do what? Unfortunately, this is a problem many of us have seen before. Pilots running around, killing each other at the spawn area, because they can't share their toys. This problem was even so big that the developers went in and made an update or a patch where the pilots couldn't use their pistols against one another. But where there is a will, there is a way.
Hey, dumbass! Watch where you're pointing that thing!
Luckily, there is a very simple solution to this. It's called sharing.
Get your targets, they're ours!
You know, maybe I should fly the Cobra, if it's okay with you. Sure, that's no problem. We can do that.
We are taking Alpha.
Check out those tunnels.
We have taken Alpha.
You wanna fly the Cobra?
Fully rearmed.
In my experience, most people are actually pretty nice, if you ask them nicely. So, it is in your power to turn this into this.
Hurry! Get in the fight, soldier! We are taking Delta!
I mentioned earlier that you should use your tactical view button to see the enemy movement on the ground. There is just one little detail I left out. To see the enemy on the ground, you need somebody to spot them for you.
Nice one.
Which brings us to our next helicopter. OH-6 Caillou. A little observation attack helicopter, in short, Loach, also known as the little bird or the flying egg, due to its shape. You still need to be combat pilot, and yes, your RPM will build up automatically, like we're used to. Now, the first time I flew the Loach, I crashed. If we say that the transport helicopter is the medium helicopter, the Cobra is the heavy helicopter, well then the Loach will be the light helicopter. It is very sensitive. So let me fill you in on how I fly my helicopters in this game. Now my keyboard and mouse are set up the exact same way, meaning if I only use the keyboard when I fly, the helicopter will react very strongly every time I push a button. But if I only use my mouse, the flying is more delicate, slower, I have more control over it. This is very good for shooting and landing. Also, you're collective. You should never just be at one place. You should always match the situation you're in. So, combining all these things together, and that is where you can begin to do some great flying. But just like everything else, it takes time to master. But let's get back to the loads here. What is your job? I kind of already mentioned it, but spotting enemy movement and tunnels. During the Vietnam War, the loads pilot would throw out smoke grenades to mark enemy movement. Luckily for us, it's a little easier, and we just have to fly over them.
Gonna take all the EMTs first.
Taking fire. Anyone hurt?
Take out the tunnel.
To spot the enemy, you gotta be flying under 100 in altitude. Anything above that, and you won't be seeing anything. Now you don't get any points for spotting the enemy. You do, however, get 2 points every time one of these enemies you have spotted gets killed. The same goes with the tunnels. Here I've been shut down, but I'm still getting points for the tunnels I spotted that the Cobra is now taking out.
Return to the combat area.
Now the loads cannot withstand a lot of ground fire, so it is important for you to maintain your speed to make it harder for the enemy to shoot you down. As a loads pilot, you're not completely defenseless. You are armed with a minigun, but the loads being a very fast and sensitive helicopter, it makes it really hard to actually hit the enemy. So, how do you do it? Well, if you click the right mouse button, you can zoom in and out, and the left mouse button to open fire. When you have become comfortable flying the loads, you can begin to do some shooting. In the start, just spray the enemy territory as you fly over it. Suppressing fire is a good thing, and you might get lucky. To improve the chances of hitting the enemy, you can slow down your helicopter and levering it more out. But be careful, you make yourself more of a target as well. Now just like the Cobra gunner, you have to get a direct hit to kill the enemy. And, just like him, you cannot take out tunnels with your minigun, like the Cobra pilot can. Unless, of course, we do it the old-fashioned way, but let's try not to end up in that situation. Like the transport helicopter, you have probably already noticed that when you get in the load, a co-pilot is spawning beside you. So what's the deal with him? Well, you can kind of see him as an extra life. In the case you get killed, you will immediately respawn as the co-pilot. You can still fly the loads and observate the enemy. You can't, however, use the minigun. And if you get killed now, the loads will crash. But all is not lost. If you fly back to the helicopter spawning area, where you usually get rearmed and get the helicopter fixed, well, you can get the pilot back as well.
Rearming. Fully rearmed.
In the case of the co-pilot getting killed, nothing much changes. You can still operate the loads as you're used to. The only difference is, if you get killed now, the loads will crash. But you can get the co-pilot back by flying to the helicopter spawning area, just as before. Which brings us to a new topic. On some maps, if the troops are doing well on the ground and are taking objectives, which are linked together, an additional landing zone where helicopters will show up, marked with an H. It works just like the helicopter spawn area. You can get fixed up, rearmed, get the additional co-pilot back. The cool thing about this is that you can save yourself the trip. But just because it's a landing zone, does not make it a safe zone. You have probably also been wondering what the back seat of the Loach is for. Well, that is for the TL. You can land and pick up any member of your team to sit in the back seat of your Loach, but the one player who gets most out of it is your team leader, and he might order you to land and do so.
Thank you, Loach, stand by. Radio man, push forward, I'm going to Loach a sec.
If, however, the TL is dead, he can choose to spawn directly in the back seat of your helicopter. If he does so, you can see it down in the left corner once he's on board.
Swordfish, I'm in the back of your thing. Recon's going up. Get his Loach up high, please.
The reason why the team leader might want to be using your Loach is that he can put down some marks that his squad leaders might have difficulty getting. Plus, there's a radio inside the helicopter, so you can call in artillery right away, using your helicopter as a command center.
3 and 5, your marks can be moved, please. 2, hold yours. I need a mark in Delta 5, urgently.
So I think we have covered the Loach pretty well, which means that we can move on to the last helicopter on this list. In the beginning of the Vietnam War, the Americans had great success using helicopters to fly troops in and out the battlefield. But it didn't take long for the Viet Cong to figure out that these helicopters were quite vulnerable when they came in for landings. So the Americans got a new idea. Take a Bell UH-1, arm it with rockets and miniguns. Let those fly in first to clear out the landing zones. This helicopter they called the Bushranger. So, to fly the Bushranger, we have to pick combat pilot role. When we're in the helicopter, we can use the numbers to switch seats. This also goes for the other helicopters, but once in the air, if you're a pilot or co-pilot, you can't switch seats anymore. As we're getting ready for liftoff, we want to make sure to get the co-pilot on board before we leave. When you fly the Bushranger, there's a lot of similarities to when you fly the Cobra. The main priority is still to take out tunnels, and just like the Cobra, the Bushranger is a very heavy helicopter. In fact, even heavier. And here comes the bad news. As a pilot, the only weapons you have access to is your rockets. You have 14 of them, and they shoot in pairs, which means 7 shots in total. Plus, they're sitting far apart from each other, and you can see that when you're shooting at targets on the ground. And to make matters even worse, depending on the angle and speed of your helicopter, you're more likely to be hitting a little underneath the sight. And don't forget, you can still zoom in by right-clicking on your mouse.
We're taking Foxtrot. We're taking Delta.
When flying the Huey gunship, there are 2 extra seats where soldiers can spawn and take control over the dual-wielding M60s. If they are good players, they know that they are now a part of the crew and should lay out suppressing fire. But every once in a while, you get players that ask you to let them off on the ground.
Hey man, are you gonna land anytime soon? Stop back here.
This is a Huey gunship, not a Huey transportation helicopter. Now you shouldn't risk the safety of your gunship going in for a landing to drop off only 2 people. Occasionally I have done it, if it has a tactical advantage, or I'm going back to base anyway.
Thank you, man. Love you. Mwah.
question I see being asked a lot is how do you fly your helicopter sideways and still keeping your eyes on the target? Well, this is a difficult maneuver, but let me try to explain how I pull it off. Alright, so let's take it from the top. You can see right now the white dot is centered in the middle. That's because we are steady. The white dot is always showing us where we're going. So if we start leaning the helicopter left, you can see the white dot is going left as well. Then I'm using the tail rotor to swing the tail left around, the same direction as we're going, keeping the nose down to keep the eyes on the target. So up, we're gonna lose it here, gonna save it, pull back, look at the target, leaning left, tail rotor left, yeah, I think we saved it, so looking good. And always adjusting with the altitude up and down. So as you can see, it's not easy because we have to use tail rotor, have to lean the helicopter, have to keep the nose down, and altitude up and down, all these things we have to adjust as we're doing it. It's not easy to pull off. Let me take a look at the feet here. You can see using the tail rotor all the time, keeping the nose down, yeah, looking good. I wouldn't recommend you try this at your first try, because it's not easy, it takes a lot of practice and you have to do all these things at the same time. But once you can do this and pull it off, it becomes really fun. Your co-pilot is gonna love you for it, and the enemy is gonna hate you for it when you just can't keep your eyes on the same target all the time. But let's get out here on a server and let me show you what it looks like in action. Nice. Now let's take a look at the Bushranger's gunner roll. I'm sure you have figured this one out already. To be the gunner in the Bushranger, we once again have to pick combat pilot roll. Now it's a matter of taking the left seat. Once sitting here, we can control the two miniguns mounted on each side of the helicopter. Similar to the Cobra, we can twist and turn these miniguns to face the direction we are looking, but I gotta warn you, we do not have a lot of wiggle room. The gunner job for the Bushranger is almost identical with the gunner from the Cobra. Since we're not flying, we might as well help the pilot by keeping an eye on the map.
Let's focus on the tunnel, do you see it?
Recon is in the air.
Yeah, I see it.
AA is up as well.
To take control of the miniguns, scroll forward with your mouse wheel and right click if you want to zoom in. Now when it comes to tunnels, your miniguns are not powerful enough to destroy them, so there's not much reason for you to shoot at them. But on the bright side, if your pilot can take them out with his rockets, you get points as well.
Got your tunnel.
But that kind of leaves you only to take care of enemy soldiers. Now because the pilot has so few rockets in his disposal, you might as well go to town with your miniguns. I have yet to play around where I run out of ammo before my pilot.
Activate the rearm, out of ammo.
Now, I don't know if you noticed, but the clip we just saw, every time we shoot at something far left or right, the opposite machine gun will cut out, meaning that we are most effective shooting at targets right in front of us. So to be an effective gunner, we need a good pilot, ones who understand this helicopter. If we take a step back and look at this gunship, it's actually not very good. It's hard to keep in the air, it's not easy to aim with, and you really have to work together with co-pilot or pilot to make it work. But that's actually why I like it, because it's not easy. If you can make it in this helicopter, you can make it in every helicopter.
Flying back.
Taking fire, check the damage.
In a case like this, where you get killed as the gunner, you will respawn back at the airbase. If the pilot hasn't got killed, he can simply fly back and pick you up. Whoa, my old head was blown off. Did you see that? If the pilot gets killed, it's just like the Cobra. Scroll back to let go of the weaponry, scroll further back to take control of the steering, up with the collective, and hey, look at this, saved by the 2D trees.
Yeah, no shit.
Now just like when we died, we respawned back at the airbase. So does the pilot, so we might as well fly back and pick him up, since we can use the weaponry anyway. So this concludes the Bushranger Gunner, but we ain't done yet. There's still a subject we haven't even touched, and that is all the things that can kill you when you take upon yourself the pilot role. Ironically enough, the first thing that can kill you is yourself, and your ability to fly the different kinds of helicopters. In the beginning, you will do a lot of mistakes like flying too close to the ground, or flying underneath an artillery strike because you didn't bother to check the map. Just because you ain't on the ground, doesn't it mean that you are safe? The solution is hard work. People will tell you not to pick the pilot if you can't fly, but if you keep on practicing, you won't be crashing so much, and down the line, you will become a great pilot. Eventually. The second thing is small arms and machine gun fire. Luckily, most of the time they don't want to give you the time of day, but if you come in too low and too slow, they will. So keep an eye out for those machine gunners. As you can see, they can and will take you down. The third thing is the Soviet-made disco machine gun, built to shoot down airplanes and helicopters. What makes this so dangerous is that it can shoot through helicopters like it was made of paper. And it doesn't require a whole lot of skill or training to be an effective disco gunner, which makes them even more dangerous. The only positive thing there is to say about the disco machine guns is that they are always standing at fixed locations, so once you get to know the maps, you know which places to avoid. The fourth thing you should be looking out for is a VC armed with an RPG. The Viet Cong side has a small amount of RPGs in their disposal. Depending on the player who picks it, will give you more or less trouble. Most of the time it's a one-shot kill, but there are those rare occasions where you can survive the impact.
Elizabeth!
out.
So what can you do against these RPGs? Well, one thing is to fly high and fast, to make it harder for them to hit you. But if you're flying a transport helicopter, you have to come in for a landing sooner or later. An enemy armed with an RPG can be spotted by a soldier, the load, or a recon plane. If you're flying a transport helicopter, you can try to avoid landing the places where RPGs has been spotted. If you're flying an armed helicopter, you can try to take them out from the sky. Again, just to point out how important it is to spot the enemy if you're flying the load for your fellow pilots.
You take the Delta.
So keep an eye out for these RPGs and return the favor.
We are taking Charlie.
The fifth and the last thing you should be looking out for is, well, this. Service to Air Missiles, in short, SAM. Developed by the Russians and given to North Vietnam to defend themselves against American bombers. This is something the North Vietnamese commander is calling in. When he does, it is active for 1 minute. If your helicopter gets targeted by a SAM, it will sound something like this.
Echo is being attacked.
You can avoid this by flying below the missile's radar system, to be more precise, under 75 in altitude.
Watch your fan.
But if you take too long to get below 75, the missile will have a lock on you and it would still take you out. A trick you can use instead of trying to get the helicopter under 75 is to fly over a landscape that is sticking up, fooling the game to believe that you are closer to the ground. And speaking about landscape sticking up, in rare occasions you can actually use it to block the missile. So when that warning light starts blinking, you better do something. The helicopter is a remarkable piece of machinery, but like all machines, it can break. Let's take a look at the damage model. The outline of the helicopter down at the left corner is not just telling you how many is on board, but also in which shape the helicopter is in. If something is yellow, it is damaged. If something is red, it is broken or is missing. Losing a skid will not have any effect on your flying, but it will have an effect on your landing. Missing one and your helicopter will tilt, making the rotor come dangerously close to the ground. Losing both skids and you have to land very careful or else you're gonna end up like a pancake on the ground, killing everybody on board. A damaged sight, bullet holes or blood splatter on the windshield will also have no effect on your flying, only your visual. But the engine and main rotor will. The transport and load helicopter are still pretty flyable to some degree, but the two gunships, which are already two heavy helicopters, if they have a broken engine, rotor or both, it's like flying a train and you definitely want to get these fixed right away. A damaged engine can be seen from outside. Your helicopter will start spitting fire and drag a white smoke trail after it, making you look like a wounded bird. A broken engine, there will be more fire and you'll be dragging black smoke.
Damn! No!
When your engine goes red, you will go down. If you're fast, you can push the other hover button, giving you a more soft landing. And, if you're lucky, you can even get the Blowing in the Wind achievement alongside with it. Losing your main Ruru, and I'm sorry, but there's nothing you can do.
Jenny!
A damaged tail rotor will give you trouble when you try to turn the helicopter. A broken tail rotor will throw you in an uncontrollable spin. You can't fly with this. First, turn off the collective until you get some altitude and get free of all the terrain. Once that is done, turn down the collective once again until you stop spinning. Then, lean the helicopter in the direction you want to go. It's not easy flying like this, but there is a chance you can make it back to helipad and get yourself fixed up. You can also lose the entire tail of the helicopter. If that happens, well, you're in big trouble.
Ursula!
Are you still alive?
Yes!
But I have no tail.
Have a nice flight. Oh, I see you're still in the air. Okay, Hex, listen, just land here again.
Crew, hold tight. We're rattling badly.
I'll try to come home.
Can you do anything?
Yeah, as soon as I can get it stop spinning, I can try to land it.
We lost the part behind, so hey, cool man! Unbelievable.
Keep your eyes on the gauges. We ain't got much left.
I made some screenshots.
Trees!
That's crazy, X! Yeah, get down! I can't believe it!
Yes.
You did it!
Ready for takeoff!
So let's say your helicopter gets shut down, but you survive. Now what? Well, keep in mind that you are a pilot, and you need to be in the air to help your team. If you're running around on the ground, trying to stay alive as long as possible, you are not helping. Otherwise, you're just a pilot sitting on the roll, not doing your job. So, you need to figure out how to get back to a helicopter as soon as possible. Which leaves you with a couple of options. The first option is to open console by pressing F3. Type suicide and hit enter. It's fast and effective, but also a little boring. The second option is to go full on rainbow mode, make a lot of noise, hoping one from the enemy team will shoot you. And, if you're really lucky, you might even step on a trap. If you step on a trap means that one from your team won't, so you save his life and you get transported right back to a new helicopter. It's a win-win situation. The third and my favorite option is to ask one of your fellow pilots for help.
Pilot down. I need an evac right away.
We have lost Bravo. Hey. We have taken control.
Thanks, man. You saved my life. And so this concludes the video. I know it was a long one, and I hope it answered all the questions you might have about the different kinds of helicopters in the game, and when you choose the pilot role, or, at the very least, that you found the video entertaining. As I am being flown back to base, I hope that now you have a fire in your belly. I want to climb aboard one of these helicopters and start flying. Remember, it takes a lot of practice, so just keep on at it. And who knows, maybe one day, you and I will be sharing a helicopter. I'm HixDK, and I'll see you guys above the tree line.